dress we could match. Did you hear that? She said she loves my dress.
Look at us, we look like all 20s together.
Yeah, that's pretty, because you guys look really good. Oh, look who it is.
Oh, hi, sorry.
Did
I accidentally just show up in your video?
Okay, you do it all the time.
Oh, that's weird. That's so sorry.
I'm not allowed to post on social media or anything without that guy being there.
Yeah, I put fries on your nose earlier.
You did. He did put a French fry on my nose. He is a professional, but he's really good at it, so he should be a pro. That's for sure.
And I love this hair.
Thank you.
His hair.
It's so much fun. You know, everybody was like, why didn't you do Bulma blue? And I'm like, well, I'm throwing it back to the old school Bulma with the purple because blue and I don't mix. I'm so pale, I'm afraid I'd look dead. So, purple's a little more life.
Yeah, the purple is popping.
Thank you. It's fun.
Did you ever see this going towards this direction, this Dragon Ball 25, 30 years later?
No, it's crazy. I think we all knew that it was a special show, and of course the fandom reminds us all the time about how it's touched their lives, which is incredibly special and awesome. But to be here at the Chinese Theater is kind of overwhelming in a wonderful way. I think we're all just so excited that finally the mainstream is recognizing anime as a viable art form that people actually are interested in storytelling from Japan. Because it really is, it's intriguing. They're really great storytellers. So I think it's about time that, you know, the U.S. starts paying attention, especially with this film. It's really great.
Were you back at anime before you got involved with the Japanese?
Yes. In fact, my little brother, Miguel, he was a huge Dragon Ball fan before it ever came to the U.S. My family's from Spain, so we would watch it every morning. Oh, it's amazing. So we would watch it every morning, and I'd have to translate for them, so he could speak Spanish very well. So I knew all about Dragon Ball, and then when he came back to the States, he started showing me Ghost in the Shell and Akira and different anime films, and he really became a fan. So when somebody, actually Jason Douglas, presented the audition opportunity to me, I thought, oh, they do that in Houston, Texas? I thought all of that was done in L.A. And he's like, no, it's here. So it was really cool to kind of be a fan of something and then step into that role.
And you've been working, I was just talking to Scully over here, and you guys have been working together for ages, and that just, I'm sure, makes it so much more special.
It does, because it's like you have a family. You know, Vic and I started about the same time. Jason started a little bit before. You know, the other guys have been going forever. So it's really cool because we do actually make each other. Which is always a good thing. And we work really well together. There's that chemistry that wouldn't be there for a cast if it was just put together. You know, we've had years and years and years of experience working together to really, like, up our game.
And you guys do record together. Do you guys bounce off each other's voices, or you record solo?
We record solo. And unfortunately, my schedule is so open that I'm usually the first person to record. Which means I'm basically speaking to a vacuum. So when we go in individually, you know, the Japanese will preview in Japanese, and then they take the Japanese out. So if there are no other English voices in there, it's just you and the wind. And that's usually what I end up with. So Sabat is very lucky because it's his studio where we record, so he usually gets in at the end. So he gets all those little singers in because he's the last to record.
Last talent right there. Enjoy the film.
Thank you. Thank you so much.